What is going on, everybody? It's your boy, the Slab Train. Welcome back to some Forza 5 news. And these screenshots that you guys are looking at are the final seven cars that they have released in their latest edition of the Forza Motorsport showroom. Now, I'm not as, I guess, enthusiastic as I am before, mainly because this is it. This is the final 35 cars. And if you count them all from each week, there's only about 250 cars out of the box, and I mean, correct me if my math is wrong, but that's not even close to Forza 4. Now, I don't know what's going on, but I don't know. I was expecting at least 500 cars. I was expecting a lot more than this. I don't really know if Turn 10's waiting for us, you know, for the last minute to say, oh, here's that second disc and we're going to throw on another 300 cars. I really don't know. And honestly, I understand the fact that they wanted to do Auto Vista for every single one of their cars. But why only 200 to 250 cars right out of the box? I mean, this is Forza Motorsport. If they want to compete with Gran Turismo 6, you guys already know Gran Turismo 6 is going to have massive amount of cars right out of the box. And that's a huge selling point. Amount of cars is massive, and I think what Turn 10 should have done, because they wanted to do Auto Vista, they wanted to have Auto Vista for all of their cars, and that's awesome. You know, they have taken the time to do a magnificent job on this Auto Vista, and it's going to be promising. It'll be very, very promising. But the fact that they're only giving us less than half of Forza 4 on the Xbox 360, it's kind of hard to comprehend. And as a Forza fan, I mean, it sucks. I'm still going to buy the game, yeah, but it's a little disappointing the fact that we're waiting, you know, we're buying this new console. I'm only buying the Xbox One for Forza 5, you know what I mean? If Forza 5 wasn't coming out, I wouldn't be getting it. So, really, I mean, I'm a little disappointed. It's a little heartbreaking knowing that there's going to be almost less than half the car list count from Forza 4. And I do understand the DLC packs coming up. 10 cars, I think it's 7 months every month. So that's 70 cars right there. We also have the LaFerrari car pack coming out day one. That's an extra 10 cars. So we're getting to about 380 or so. Still though, I mean, for a Forza Motorsport title for next gen, I was expecting something big. I was expecting a lot of stuff. I mean, we're going to have to wait till the day that we get the game in our hands, but I don't understand why they did this. And I mean, I respect the fact that they've taken their time with these cars and they look absolutely beautiful, you know, everything looks absolutely amazing, but I just feel that there should be more cars in this game right out of the box, especially competing with Gran Turismo 6. You know, Gran Turismo 6 is going to be taking advantage of that and coming out strong out of the gate. So we're going to have to wait and see what happens with that. But I just want to go over quickly the top cars out of this new list that I wanted to kind of go over. The 69 Ford Mustang Boss 302 is beautiful. I cannot wait to get my hands on that thing. That thing looks absolutely gorgeous. Another one, the 2013 GT86, or the, if I'm not mistaken, that thing is going to be an absolute monster. We also have the 57 Ferrari Testarossa. All the open wheels cars, we have the 98 Super coming in, the 71 Hemi Cuda, the 2000 Silvia Spec R, we have the Enzo coming back in, the Chevelle SS, that was a fan favorite of mine, so I'm glad that they brought that back. The Subaru BRZ is going to be in Forza 5, which is a big, big news on that. We have the 93 Cobra R, and what else is very nice on that? The 69 Camaro SS Coupe. So I don't know, gentlemen. Let me know in the comments what you guys think about this. Me, personally, the fact that we've seen Forza 4 do some outstanding things, you know, they've done some crazy feats, you know, they've hit almost 500 cars on their roster, but we can't break 300 out of the box on a next-gen console. It's a little bit hard to kind of comprehend, and I really hope that there's a reason for this, but we're going to have to wait and see, guys. I hope you guys did enjoy the video. If you did, make sure you guys leave a like and a comment. It's your boy, the Slab Train. I'm out. Peace. Don't bring me back.